Vitamin D is completely different from most vitamins. In fact, it's actually a steroid hormone produced from cholesterol when your body is exposed to the sun. It's a fat-soluble vitamin, meaning that it dissolves in fats and oils and usually is stored in your body for long periods of time. There are mainly two types of vitamin D. You got D3, cholecalciferol, which is found in fatty fish and egg yolks, and then you got D2, ergocalciferol, found in some plants and mushrooms. D3 is more effective in raising your levels of vitamin D altogether, so it's going to be the one that I'll focus on in this video. The big question everyone likes to ask me in the pharmacy about this vitamin is, can I get it from the sun? Well, it depends. If you live in an area with lots of sunshine, like in LA where I'm currently in, you can probably get enough of the vitamin D you need by being outside a few times per week. Keep in mind, this depends though. For most days of the week, 15 minutes of sun will suffice for a person with lighter skin due to less melanin getting more sun exposure, to a couple of hours for a person with dark skin who, let's say, has more melanin. Keep in mind though, if you're only exposing your face and hands, you may not be getting enough vitamin D. But also don't forget, your exposure time should depend on how sensitive your skin is already to the sun. This is because sunburns can cause premature aging and raise your skin cancer risk. So carry sunscreen with you when you go out to absorb some D's. If you plan to stay out longer than 15 to 20 minutes, that is. While you're at it, don't forget to check out my video on sunscreen to learn how to stay protected from sunburns, and also smash that like button below. Because vitamin D gets stored in your body for weeks or months at a time, you only need so much of the sunshine to keep your blood levels of vitamin D in check, so it's not necessary to obsess about it, especially if you are supplementing. That being said, many people also don't have access to sunshine for most of the year, and vitamin D deficiency becomes a real thing, especially among older adults, because their skin already has a harder time converting vitamin D to its active form when exposed to the sun, and their kidneys are less able to convert vitamin D as well, which can also lead to osteoporosis and fall risks. In fact, people who work indoors, wear extensive clothing, regularly use sunblock, are dark-skinned, obese, or consciously avoid the sun are all at a risk for vitamin D deficiency. In fact, vitamin D deficiency is so common that an estimated 1 billion people worldwide have low levels of vitamin D in their blood. Other people who may be vitamin D deficient are people who spend all day indoors, people who live in areas with high pollution, people with Crohn's disease or celiac disease. So check in with your doctor to have your vitamin D levels measured if you are worried you may not be getting enough. The cutoff for vitamin D deficiency is less than 20 nanograms per milliliter, and you'd ideally want your levels to be above 30. Supplementation may be necessary for some people, and it may be given with calcium for bone health, as calcium is what's used to build bones and vitamin D is what's used to effectively absorb that calcium. So the recommended dietary intake for vitamin D maintenance therapy is 600 IU or 15 micrograms for adults, and the upper level intake is maxed out at 4,000 IUs a day. And again, that's for adults. 4,000 IU is the safe upper limit according to the Institute of Medicine. So make sure not to take more than that without consulting your doctor first. Keep in mind, your first dose may be different if your doctor recommends using it for osteoporosis or other health reasons. Overall, vitamin D is essential to our health, as it helps strengthen our bones, helps us absorb calcium better, which allows us to keep our muscles healthy and moving the way it should. It also helps our nerves to carry messages between the brain and the rest of the body. The fascinating part is the investigation of the role of vitamin D in certain viral infections affecting the lungs, which you may have all heard by now. I'd love to discuss that in the comments below though. I hope the video helped clarify some questions surrounding vitamin D and was useful to you. Let me know what your experiences are with vitamin D, if you feel like you aren't getting enough of it, or if you have any further questions, please leave them all below and I'll get to answering all of them for you. It also means a lot that you made it this far in the video. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe, and as always, see you on the next one.